Well, we are live right now. This is the start of our journey. Going to Alaska. There's the man. There's the man right there.
There's some killing to do.
Yes, sir. There's his beloved wife, Julie. She's also taking a trip to Vegas.
I can taste that meat already.
We are just passing through the Ship Canal Bridge in beautiful city of Seattle. Well, it used to be beautiful until the trappers moved in. This is Jim right here, the owner, actually, of Trail Ridge.
You just never know what you're going to see out of
Jim. Exactly.
Yeah. Daniel works for them. I said earlier Daniel's the owner, but you are the owner, Jim.
Yep.
Jim, what's your last name?
Oh, you think I should say that? Oh.
Trail Ridge right there.
Jensen.
Jensen, okay.
Jim Jensen.
All right.
This must be a daughter.
I just want to set the record straight that I thought Daniel was yours, but it's you, sir. I stand corrected.
But who?
Boyfriend too.
Hi guys, it's August 22nd, 2015. We are at camp right now. This is a lake about 200 miles or so from northwest of Anchorage, called Little Axeburg Lake. A-X-E-B-U-R-G, at least that's what the owner says. Trail Ridge Airways. And this is our surrounding lake. Pretty barren, there's really no trees. And this is where we set up camp. August 22nd, 2015, caribou hunting. So, hopefully tomorrow we can wake up early and see some activity up in the hills. See where we're going. We saw, let's see, when we were putting up the tent, we saw a caribou in that distance right there across the lake, and then there were two caribous and that bluff right there. Coming up here, being dropped off by a beaver airplane, float plane, and we saw a grizzly, a sow, and two cubs. Just let me zoom it, if I can zoom it. Hold on here. Just beyond that hill right there. There was a grizzly sow and two cubs, and then probably 4 miles from here there was a solo black bear that looked very huge from the airplane. So the fun starts tomorrow, guys. Well, let me do this recording again because it might not have recorded properly last time. We are at camp right now. There's a young bull over there across the lake at, what was the range?
354 yards.
354 yards. He's just maybe washing up. He's just by the water.
Just trying to keep cool.
Keep cool.
Keep the bugs or flies away from him.
And that's where he's at. He came down all the way north side of the lake. You can't see it from that bush, and he walked all the way, and there he is. And I'm gonna take away the zoom. 300, what was that?
354 yards.
There's Chris right there. There's yours truly.
Second bird. How do you zoom this? I was going to zoom right past you onto the bird. Second bird.
Well, this is me and Chris right here, hunkered down in the tent. Third day of hunting, what's that, August 25.
Yep.
Very foggy, we couldn't even see 50 yards ahead of us. So, came back down and had some mountain house. And
saw a bear and four caribou before the fog drifted in this thick.
This is inside our tent right here. That's my side. We are actually eating in the vestibule. right here. And that's Chris's side right there. That's our house. If you call it a house. Signing off.
Makes good shelter.
Well, 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 today is August 27th. This is what we do when we're not hunting. Surprisingly, it's been raining for 3 days in just the last 20 minutes. This is
starting to dry out.
It's starting to dry out, and blue skies are starting to appear. Clouds are breaking up. But we've been hunkered down here for the last, 24 hours or so. That's my partner in crime right there.
Yeah, I went out this morning and got my share of wetness and salt.
And
cold.
Yeah. There's me. So I just got done washing the plates and forks and dishes at the lake and checking our meat. Because we had to repack it again because damn gophers or prairie dogs got to it. Well, two of them, but one got away. I shot the other one, so too bad, so sad for that guy. Shot it with my .40 caliber pistol. But this is us in the tent.
Call him Quick Draw Tom. Don't mess with his meat.
Hi guys, today is August 30 and it is snowing right now at Little Axburg Lake. That's Chris coming out of the tent.
Hey, get any more snow, we can have a snowball fight.
That's right. We've been ready to be picked up yesterday. Today we talked to the pilot and we might not get picked up today, so tomorrow really is our schedule. For pickup, August 31st, so we'll see.
Yeah, the hang-up is Merrill Pass.
That's right.
The hang-up this morning is fairly clear here, but Merrill Pass was socked in, so they couldn't fly through the pass to get to us.
Yep, and I'm going to zoom on our meat right there. Okay, where's that at? There it is. That's the meat. The the lake.
I'm gonna try to climb up here, hill, so you can get a good perspective of where we are situated. Climbing up a hill, and the tent's there, the lake's there. And just straight up from where I'm pointing, there's supposed to be snow-capped mountains, but due to low ceiling and low visibility, you can't see it. Okay, talk to you later, guys. Good morning. Today is August 31st, 2015. We were begging to be picked up 3 days ago, but there's just no letting up with the low clouds and bad visibility. Yesterday we got snowed in. There's a little bit of break it up right there, so that is our window. But it's freezing cold, snow. Well, Chris and I were talking about the only thing missing in this trip was snow, and
we got it.
God heard us. We got snow. We got snow. Thank you, Lord. We're gonna make a call to have them pick us up. Break up this camp and off we go.
Yep.
Well, let me tell you something about our pickup day today. Today is still August 31st, 2015. What happened was the plane picked us up, or landed at Little Axburg Lake, and the wind shifted. So Adam, the pilot, decided to load up all our provisions first and our personal stuff, while Chris is there left at the other lake watching the meet. And so they're gonna load up the meat in the backside of the plane, fly out of that lake, and then pick me up here. So I am alone in this lake right now. I have no idea where I'm at. Hopefully they'll pick me up. He said in 20 minutes. So he had to shuttle stuff, because if he didn't do that, then we might not be able to fly out of that lake. So he had to shuttle supplies first, this one, and then pick up the meat, then reload this one on the plane, and then out we go back to Anchorage. Okay, this is our journey. Signing out. So we want to recap. Today is September 1, 2015. We want to recap our hunting trip with our outfitter that provided us with the provisions.
Yeah, the camping gear.
Camping gear. That is Alaska Bush Adventures. Our hunting trip was from August 22 through August 31st. We came back yesterday, and to the owner of the Alaska Bush Adventure, Hugh Les Crank. Les, I can't thank you enough. My name is Tom Carceliar, and my partner Chris Mallory, he'll speak after me. Thank you so much for the provisions, the new tent, the new stove, the new propane lantern, all the food in the tote. Thank you so much, and thank you for hooking us up with the float plane. I'm not gonna mention the company, but
I'll mention it,
but thank you so much for the whole trip. We, as you will see in the video we'll send you, and still pictures, we really have bagged our game. 2 caribous in 10 days. That's perfect. So that's all I have to say. Thank you so much. Anybody that wants to do this on your own, unguided caribou hunting or any kind of hunting, I would highly recommend Alaska Bush Adventures for your trip. Chris?
Les, we had a great time. The equipment you had set up for us, that you had packed for us, was excellent. Very good shape. I had to let a bigger caribou go because I was a little bit leery about whether we would be able to haul it out all in one load on the float plane. Alaska Bush Adventures, actually the float plane company was Trail Ridge Air. But once we loaded the caribou up, I took the little smaller one, passed up on a bigger one. Once we got it all loaded up, I realized, I should have shot that bigger one. But we're very happy. We're very pleased with the adventure. Thanks a lot.
All right. Till we have another adventure again, Les. Thank you.
Yeah.